I haven't slept. No one has slept. Not for 3 days, not since the black storm in the northern ranges. Not since the nightmares began. Violent and twisted night terrors. They whisper to us, tempt us, threaten us, beguile us. They promise terrible things in return for even more terrible acts. My husband, Deniris, went to Alliston to find a doctor who might help. He should have been back yesterday. I fear for him. I fear for all of us. It has been a little over a week since the black storm. My husband has not returned, and sickness now sweeps through our village. Many have died, and those who have lived have changed. These were folk we once called neighbor and friend. Now they limp and stagger through the night, their deformities as grotesque as the madness in their eyes. The moon was full the night of the black storm. It is full again. They have come for me. They have come for my daughters. Bravallo called out while the others skulked and muttered in the darkness. Corrin went to them, arms open, welcoming. The nightmares told her to. My uncle tried to stop her. Bravallo crushed his skull with his smith's hammer. I barred the doors and windows, but they screamed like monkeys and beat themselves bloody trying to get in. I had no choice. I took my two youngest and fled through the cellar, following the tunnel to the mill. All we can do is hide and hope. God help us. Three Lunari gone now since it all began. Perhaps I am the only one who still looks upon Lunaris, who remembers her name. Soon, I will be gone, and the moon will go on alone. My husband has returned, and he hunts for me. My dead husband hunts me. Corrin, too, and my uncle. corpses rise and walk and feed. My girls, they walk now and feed. God has forsaken us. Lunaris is my witness. Tonight, I return to my family.
Thank you. So you're Alira's lapdog, are you? I could be wasting the last of my breath here, but you're chasing the wrong tail. Once Alira's done with you, those brave guts of yours will be steaming on the ground. Here's the truth of it. Oak and Alira, they care for nothing and no one. Me, I care about a thing called arithmetic. You go take two heads and two amulets. Bring them to me and you get half the power. That add up right to you?
Not even the life you wasted on spite and avarice.
I've seen many an exile come and go, into the forest or into the ground. You seem different somehow. Different good, different bad, it's hard to tell at this stage. The name is Eremir, and for now you have the benefit of my doubt. Those bandits you've encountered out there, they're the dregs of Oriath. And with any foul broth, the nastiest chunks bubble to the surface. The lords of larceny, Oak, Kraytin, and Alira, the self-appointed monarchs of the forest. Thanks to you, Kraytin and his river rats are food for gulls and eels, giving rather than taking for once in their misguided lives. Yet Alira remains in the west, Oak in the north, and this village, this tribe, we continue to pay their taxes. I would never venture to say that life in Raetlast is easy, but with Alira and Oak gone, well, living here might just become possible.
Let us speak of life will lose its way in the darkness to come. This land must take its final rest so that it can rise once again in...
Of reckoning, find you, Doedri Stamatis, guilty of the following transgressions against God. Perversion of God's creation. Promotion of heretical beliefs. Unlawful enslavement of eternal citizens. Torture of the innocent. Murder of the servants of purity. For these most severe crimes, I do sentence Doedri Darktongue to burn at the stake till naught is left but ash. May her life serve as penance for the lives she has taken, and let purity sweep away the dust of her deeds from our firmament. High Templar Vol, commander of the Army of Purity.
Completed my errand, Exile. Forgive my surprise, but I'm simply not used to reliability from the living. The dead are loyal beyond question, but the living, they have their own needs and lusts, fears and fancies. Easily distracted they are. I compliment you on your powers of concentration, Exile. And should you note my presence in the forest encampment, do engage me in discourse, I am sure I can make use of that keen focus of yours again.
I am no beast of burden.
So Creighton has fallen. A worthy achievement on your part. And yet you serve Alira? Not so worthy. You strike me as someone who craves a higher purpose than that. Something like peace. Every day my brethren must battle and die with Alira's enthralled wretches. To spare the lives of many, you need take only one. But if peace isn't reward enough for you, bring me the amulet that hangs around Alira's worthless neck. I trust you have Creighton's in hand already? I thought so. When joined with mine, those trinkets will forge us a new strength, you and I. The strength to bring about peace.
I caught some rats in my traps today. They told me an amusing tale. Their rat king, Creighton, dead. And yet now you're one of Oak's squawking little parrots? Look at the aura on you, bright as the sunset before a storm, not the manner of a minion. Oak's no doubt spun you a line about divvying up the power of the amulets between the two of you. No, he'll take the power for himself and crack your head open like a walnut. Seen him do the likes of that 100 times over. Bring me a pair of amulets and Oak's lying tongue, and I promise to make you part of that power. I believe in friendship, and I can be a fine friend to those who treat me sweetly.
Ah!
what true friendship is.
Today I am king, unquestioned, unrivaled. A fine feeling indeed. Not much of a kingdom to speak of, but it's a start. Now, hand me those amulets so that I may reward my most resourceful of subjects. Quite the rush to the head, that. You keep this as a souvenir of your fine efforts. Now be on your way. Find yourself a patch of dirt to call your own far from here. As you may have gathered, I have little tolerance for neighbors.
The lair of a toy maker with pretensions of godhood. Okay.
over here, Exile. Is crawling with vermin. Eight-legged, no-legged, and everything in between. Life here has become twisted and hateful, and it's eating Rayclast alive. Unless we do something about it, unless we clear away this infestation, nature doesn't stand a chance while it has creatures like that at its throat. I've a certain pack of vermin in mind. A truly twisted and ravenous lot. They range across quite a large territory, so be prepared to cover some ground. Hunt them down wherever they might be and put an end to them. For this hunt, I'm going to share a piece of bushcraft with you. Well, bushcraft smeared with thaumaturgy. The corrupted creatures tend to mark their territory with their foulness. This trick allows you to pick up that scent and follow it home. The whole thing stinks of corruption, I know. But you can't expect to put your nose to the ground without getting it dirty.
I bequeath this transmuter device to you, Inquisitor Manigaro, in recognition of your devotion to our sublime art. May it be the chariot that conveys your dreams into reality. Malachi, Thaumaturge Laureate to the Empire.
To damnation with piety. She was after one of Malagaro's creations, the baleful gem. You have it? Good. It's something that wicked woman must never get her hands on. You've seen the encampment on top of the dam. Bring the baleful gem and meet me there. My days with the Ebony Legion are done.
Thank you. The path to justice is slender and perfidious, fraught with missteps of ambition and despair, egotism and doubt. Should you choose this road, beware those who would waylay your hopes and disembowel your dreams. Remain sure and remain true.
or not.
You hear that? That's the sound of nature taking its first decent breath in far too long. The more vermin we turn into fertilizer, the more nature can breathe and grow in peace. Come see me when you're next in the forest encampment. I can always use a good color.
Here I stand in the light of day, an impossible dream for a woman caged in horror. Thank you again for saving my sorry hide. Sorry in so many ways that I simply can't begin. Actually, that's not true. I can begin by offering you more than mere thanks. I can offer you my allegiance and my mind, the sharpest weapon that I possess. My knowledge is your knowledge, Savior. The tree that Gina calls Lerata is the only thing standing between piety and whatever awaits behind that ancient gateway to the northwest. Melagaro's spike would pierce even the toughest bark. Inject the baleful gem's essence into the tree. Something so toxic will surely weaken, if not kill, the tree. I'm loath to see such a majestic life ended so cruelly. But please, get inside that Vile ruin before Piety does and ensure there's nothing there that could further her twisted cause.
The Oriathan girl, she is alive. She wants to stay with us, not to go back to her people. I say we take her traitor's heart to the chief. Ask that the warriors in black leave us be. I sleep less, but no more, thanks to you. Elena gave me these. Use it or cast it away. I do not care. I have no time for Helena's breed of peace. exiles,